G'day, Gary from Simple Audio Tips. In this 90-second segment, you're going to learn how to make the connections for a constant voltage speaker system. Around the 1920s or 30s, the constant voltage speaker system started to be used, and it remains to be the best way to distribute sound over long cable runs with multiple speakers. And if you don't have speakers with switchable output levels, setting up these ceiling speakers with all these leads can be a real nightmare. But to make it simple, there's only two connections needed for each speaker. Now, on this particular speaker, the coloured leads or connections vary the output from between 2.5 and 15 watts. So effectively, you've got the ability to increase the volume or decrease the volume relative to other speakers on the cable run. So let's use an example. If you wanted to select 10 watts, then you'd choose the common terminal, and in this case it's the black wire, plus the 10 watt terminal or wire, in this case it's the red wire. Other speakers might have a terminal block that you can configure and select whatever wattage you want, but you need to follow the instructions to do that. But a word of warning at this particular point, you need to take note of how much power each speaker is consuming and total these up, making sure not to exceed the output of the amplifier. Of course, the reason for this is so you don't overload it and cause clipping or distortion. Now, let's use this installation as an example. If you want to install 10 speakers and they're wired at 10 watts each, you would be loading the amplifier with 100 watts. So, if you chose a 120-watt amplifier, that'd be fine. So all you need to do now is connect the main feed line to the speaker, ensuring that the polarity remains the same relative to all the other speakers so that they're in phase with each other. Now, we'll talk about phasing and phase checking in a future video, but be sure to subscribe to our channel so you can enjoy more Simple Audio Tips.